บ่อฝรั่ง community is one of the housing project under the big program of community driven housing project in Thailand. You may heard about it, Ban Man Kong project within CODI. CODI is the public organization who hold this program since 2003. No? It's almost 18 years. And this is in Bangkok. You can see from the photo. This is the recent photo of the development, but I will show you the process and the story that it begin in 2013. And you can see this is a new CBD of Bangkok. The land is very expensive. You may not believe that 1 acre can cost like a $60 million. And the people living here and can develop their housing here. It's a long story and it's a lot of difficulty that we go through. To give you a background of Ban Man Kong project, it started in 2003. And now we can work in 430 cities, you know, all over Thailand. You can see the red dot that show the location of the project. Bangkok is the capital city. It's in the middle of Thailand. And Bo Phrang is one of this program. And this is the location of Bangkok and the project. I just want to show you that the red dot is the location of the Bo Phrang community. You can see that it's very expensive area because they plan to develop a new CBD in this area. And this is the photo before the development. The settlement start maybe in 1960, it's long ago. This area used to be a pond because Siam Cement Group, which is a big company to produce cement in Thailand, they found that this land have a big black soil that they use for produce cement, so they dug up this area and it's become a big pond. And some of the area they use for the worker camp since 1960. And when the pond is finished, they don't have a black clay or black soil anymore. So they stopped it in 1965, but the people start to coming to the city and they migrate around the pond. So, when we start the project in 2010, during that time, we did the mapping and the survey together with the people. We found that it have like a 250 family living here, divided into a 5 settlement during that time. Then CODI start to organize them, encourage them to start saving and link with the local government. But the real development start in 2013 because of the landowner, which is SCG, no? Siam Cement Group, want to develop this land into a park. So they're quite not sure what to do with the communities, but they don't want to evict them. So CODI start to negotiate together with the community network in Bangkok. So they come up with the idea of land sharing to put together the communities in this area that they have 4 acres of land. And then they can return the rest of the land for SCG to develop a park. But because of the land is very expensive, so I think SCG thinking a lot to give this piece of land to the people. So it's a long negotiation, and you can see this is the situation before the development from 1960 to 2013. And we bring two university faculty of architecture from two university, Asomsin University and Sipathum University to working with this community to do a planning. We need support from university because they can be good supporter to the community to negotiate with the SCG as well. So it's been like a one year to develop a land sharing plan and a lot of meeting with the landowner. So finally we got the final idea of having 105 row house. You can see this, and in the blue area they will build a low-rise apartment of 4-story, 133 unit for the extended family. So altogether, they have like a 242 unit, plus 4 units for elderly who live alone. This will be like a social welfare unit on the first floor of apartment unit. From the total area of 24.4 acre, include the lake, include the pond, the community will use just 4 acre of land to make a settlement for 242 unit, no? And they will return 20.4 acre for SCG to develop as a public space. And I think one reason that the landowner gave the land to the people, because of they realized that the people really organized, they do the saving group, and they start the first phase of row house of 45 unit, and they show that they repair very well and they organize the space, they clean the place very well. That give a confidence to the landowner to develop the whole project. And because of this land, actually by law, they cannot build any high rise thing because they don't have access. So to build a community that is okay, because they can use an informal road to link with the railway land, no? Which is accessible to the main road. And this is like a dream model at the beginning did by the Sri Pathum University Faculty of Architecture. And in terms of budget, you can see that we have like a four type of building. The first one is row house. In this way, people pay back $100 per month for 15 years. They got loan from Cody, you know? And the second part is an apartment. They pay back $80 per month for 15 years. So for apartment unit, it need a lot of subsidy because of the construction cost is quite high. And the last part is the social unit for elderly who live alone. They provide 4 units for elderly who live alone, and the cooperative will take care of them. And in 2013, they set up a cooperative to deal with this project and get loan from Cody. The cost of development in total is 7.1 million. You can see that it's quite a lot, because of 3 million is investment from SCG themselves to develop a park. But if we calculate only the housing, it's around $4 million. But $1.4 million is it's a loan from Cody that it will go back to Cody fund. And this is the latest photo, maybe a few months ago, when the apartment is almost finished, and Cody and SCG organized the like a tour to visit and to check the construction. And this is some photo of the income generation during the project. I think it's at the beginning is the landowner quite hesitate to give the land to the people, because they not believe people can organize. But through the process of working together and the people, they show the ability to manage the fund and to deal with the development. So it give a confidence to the landowner. So finally, SCG give this part of land to the Treasury Department, which is a government organization who deal with public land in Thailand, to own this part of land, and the community will get long-term lease, maybe 15 years or 30 years for this part of land. But it's still in the process of of dialogue about how to get lease, how much that the people have to pay per year for their land. So it will final at the end of this year, I think.
All right, thank you,
yeah.
Nad. That's quite an impressive accomplishment. I have a question for Nat in Bangkok. You talked about Cody providing a loan, and so I'm just wondering where the financing comes from. Like where does Cody get the funding from?
Cody is a public organization, but it's work with the government. The funding come from government, but from the project, I think. Maybe 40% of the subsidy came from government lottery fund. This is another government unit because the SCG they have some link with the government of lottery fund. So they convinced it that to give subsidy for this project can open up to the new park of Bangkok, something like that.
Okay. And you also mentioned something about the income generation. There was one of the photos was referring to that. So what kind of activities are they doing to generate income?
Some of the people, they are garbage collector, no? They recycle the plastic and other things. So that's their income. And when we start the first phase of housing, they start to experiment different kind of income generation, like plant vegetable, organic vegetable. And then because of SCG is came to link with them and want to support this kind of income generation initiative. So they provide some technical support, like train people to do a mushroom plantation. And mainly I think they want to support people to do the organic plantation because the people already use it for their for themselves and sell some part for it, and this can be a part of a green area that they want to develop. It should be provide some area for organic vegetable for the city, and the people will work for it and take care of this part. And I think that's like a combine. This project is powerful in that way because of we have a private sector, we have a lot of money, you know. SCG is one of the biggest company in Thailand to produce cement. When we can convince them to understand that they can support the people initiative, not just provide the idea, not for people to do what they like, but you know, listening and support the initiative from the people, I think this is a big success, because most of the company they tend to have their own agenda. They want to do CSR this and that, and little by little they be part of a process, and they are part of joint committee, you know? So they learn the people process. I think this is quite important to change their mindset that the poor people, they need opportunity. They have a lot of idea.
Nat, I wanted to ask you about the cooperative, the housing cooperative lease. They have a lease from the state that lasts like 30 years. And what happens after the 30 years if the lease isn't renewed by the government? Is there a danger of the community being evicted again, or the land being sold for other type of interests?
From our project, we have a MOU, you know, with the Treasury Department or other department that own the government land. Maximum now the people can get like a 30-year lease. And in the concept that we will like have a continue the lease again after 30 years, actually, that's a promise from the government. But because it never happened before to have a community form a cooperative and lease the land, you know. In the past, the government just leased the land for individual. So it's not usual for the government to have a trust for this. So yeah, actually it's not a clear in term of policy But we convinced the network that we need to work on this kind of community land trust, community law, whatever, to convince the government to give a long term security for this kind of project. It's in the process, and one of the most difficult process in Thailand to accessible to the government land in the long term. But we can say that now we can succeed, yeah, within 30 years.